Oh, sir, how do you feel about your losses last week?
I don't like, I know my team played well, so,
Hey, Will, what you doing?
Nothing, I'm just giving this interview. I took a, it was a good fought game, really.
What was it, what's the interview about again?
I lost this week in fantasy football.
Who'd you play? Oh!
We're back, baby.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Will Hebert Show with Will Hebert. I'm Will Hebert.
And I'm Mason Hebert.
For the second week in a row, we have the Hebert brothers.
We do.
Doing this thing, and I'm very excited to see how this goes. But anyway, week two, let's jump into it, shall we?
Let's jump in.
All right.
So game number one this week, we have number 8 in the league, Dad B3 Hooked on a Thielen, playing number 5 Mom's Dixie Chicks. And honestly, it's Dad. If I hadn't seen the scores, I still could have told you who lost this game. And it, just like anybody predicted, it was Dad by a score of 88-126. A very rough loss there by you, Dad.
Big guy, another straight game of less than 90 points. This is, what's going on?
His scoring looks like the Steelers scoring right now. So, but with that said, your Pittsburgh defense got 23. Tucker had a nice game, and both of them were on your bench.
Yep, the sixth and seventh
pick of your draft. You know, you could have taken a top flight wide receiver. Instead, you went, I want Tucker in the Steelers defense, and you put them on the bench. And so that really helped you out, though, because you went and grabbed the Giants defense playing the Cardinals, and they got you -2 points. So,
yep,
rough week there, Dad. You did have Hurts have a nice game, but that's about it. And then Mom's Dixie Chicks, very unfortunate. Nick Chubb for your team got what should be a season-ending injury.
If not career-ending. Prayers up to Nick Chubb, everyone. Yeah.
Prayers up. But your team played a phenomenal game this week. Well done.
Well done, Mom. All right, our next game we have number 3, Will Berry, the strongest of Wills, taking on number 4, Didi's Yellowstone Bisons. A classic name, the Yellowstone Bisons.
Absolutely.
And also a classic victory for Didi. Final score, 125-110. Will Berry, your first L in the league. It happens to everyone. No worries there, I guess, except for Porter. Porter somehow doesn't figure that one out. Anyway, Berry, actually a good week from you. Derrick Henry's 18, Devonta Smith's 23. Very good week for you. Unfortunately, Deontay Johnson, J.K. Dobbins for you are on IR. Always tough to see that. So maybe speedy recovery for them. As for Didi, he advances to 2-0, one of two teams to do so this year. Josh Allen, Christian McCaffrey, and Keenan Allen, star players for your team with well over 20 points each. So, congrats to Didi.
Absolutely. What a week, Didi.
On to game 3.
All right, game 3, we have number 2 in the league, my very own Ray Rice's Elevator Service, taking on the number 1 in the league, Nene's Lightning Lady. And kind of an unfortunate matchup for me on this one. Nene is just out here steamrolling everyone. She's 2-0 on the season now, beating me by a score of 129-107. Good week for Nene, too. Mahomes got 21. Pollard and Lamb got over 20 points. Just, Nene's got a lot of talent on her roster.
Congrats to Nene, absolutely.
Big congrats to Nene. And for me, I had Justin Jefferson had a nice game. Bijan had a nice game. Except I made a poor managerial decision putting Garrett Wilson, my second round pick, on the bench this week. And he put up 16. And so,
yeah, would have helped.
Unfortunate. It would have helped, but... Yeah.
So
that's that for that game.
Yeah. And there you go. You heard it here first. Our final game may be the closest game I've ever seen in the history of fantasy football. My 7th seeded Raiders of the Lost Yard took on number 6 Porter's Ingram Toenails. Final score, and I have to read the decimal points. That's how close this game was. 150.88 for me. to Porter's 151.08. Now, if you're good at math, that's 0.2 points or 2 yards. And that is how close this game was. Unbelievable game. I can't even be mad. These were the two highest scoring teams in the league, and we got an absolute barn burner out of it, and I'm just upset to be on the losing end of it. For my team, Puka Nacua, you know, with a 30 spot. Yeah, that happens. Rashad White had 21, and it was a tough blow for me to not have Cooper Kupp or Austin Ekeler. But I did get Mark Andrews back, which was nice. But yeah, hopefully my team just continues to get healthier instead of the alternative. As for Porter's team, T. Higgins with 29 going off, and Saquon Barkley with 27, and a milestone here for Porter, his first ever victory against me. And yep, it took him 2 years to do it.
It did take him 2 years, but many more to come.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Anyway, moving on, we now have, what comes next?
There's awards coming next?
I think so. Yeah, awards, the awards section. Next.
All right, so did you want to talk or something?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay, fine. First up on the awards is, as always, the Golden Chainsaw. And for this week, for this week, the Golden Chainsaw goes to Porter. Highest scorer of the week and first victory over Will ever. Why'd you put that in the notes? Was it that important?
It was that important.
So, Porter, way to get your first victory over Will. Way to score the most points of the week. Just an absolute domination this
week. I'm not going to lie. I think it was probably a good thing that I dropped this week to Porter, because honestly, I don't think he would have been able to handle all the trash talk if I'd gotten 3-0 in 2 years over him. So, this is probably for the best. For the best. Vacuum Award. Last week it went to me, but this week it goes to Dad, and rightfully. B3, the big guy, lowest score in the league for the second straight week. You are yet to break 90 points. Like, what is going on? You are 2 years removed from a title. Get your stuff together. There you go.
Yep. All right. Next up, we have Insightful Foresight, and that one goes to Nini.
Nice.
Nini had a wonderful week, 129 points, and if you took the best of her starters and bench, her best possible lineup, the people she started was only 4 points away from the perfect lineup she could have had. So
well done.
Wonderfully done, Nini. Just a good job this week.
I would like to take the Cond Award. This goes to me for being the second highest scorer in the league, and I happen to play the first highest scorer, and now I fall to 0-2 unrightfully. This is some bull crap. This sucks. It's a sham. But don't worry. We're coming back next week. We're going to get a dub, and we're gonna be the one seed going in the playoffs. Yeah, it's happening. AP poll.
AP poll.
You ready?
Ready.
All right. Number one and number two come to no surprise. Number one is Nini, sitting at 2-0. Most points scored in the league. Absolutely fantastic performance to open the season.
Absolutely dominating.
Absolutely. And number two is Didi, our only other 2-0 team. And both of them are off to strong starts.
Very strong. Let's see. Number three, we got a high jumper of this one. Porter at number three, now 1-1 on the season. Playing very strong. Last week he had a good week and lost, and this week he has a good week. He's just playing good.
Mm-hmm.
And number four, we've got Mom, also at 1-1. Very deserving. She's playing well.
Yep. Strong week this week for Mom. Win over Dad. Number five is Mason, falling from 2, but still fine at 1-1 overall on the season. Number six, Barry, 1-1 also. And yeah, you're all is well for all teams so far, I think, except for, of course, number eight. But
so number seven, Will at 0-2. He scored a lot of points this week, but he's still falling to 0-2, so maybe he's trending in the right direction. And then number eight, of course, we have the big guy, B3. 0-2, and it's not even a surprise. He is yet to crack 90, and he won't get out of that eight spot until he does something. So, yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know who's playing him next week, but I would be very excited if he is on on your schedule.
Yeah. Absolutely. Pretty much a bye week.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. And for next week, let's see what we got going on. First of all, number 4-seeded Mom takes on number 6, Barry. And honestly, I love this matchup. 2-1-1 teams trying to show who really wants to be in the playoffs this year. And I think that'll be a fantastic matchup.
All right. We have number 5, me, against number 8, Dad. You know, I may be in the bottom half of the league rankings, but we should have a pretty easy week this week. All right, Dad, try and crack 90, please.
Speaking of easy weeks, I plan to hand Nene her first loss. Number 1, Nene, against number 7, my Raiders of the Lost Yard. And I feel very excited for my team and this coming week. I really do. So, Nene, watch out. You're next.
Yeah, you're fine. And then finally, we have number 2, Didi, against number 3, Porter, shaping up to be a wonderful matchup.
Battle of the heavyweights right there.
Absolutely. 2-0, Didi, and Porter, who has just gone crazy on points. This is shaping up to be a really good matchup. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, that's what we have for next week.
There you go. And that reminds me, we have not announced our punishment for this year. If you don't already know, we have a personal challenge between the two of us for whoever finishes worse between us in the league.
Mm-hmm. You may remember that I had to do a waffle challenge, which was on the show last year.
That was a great, great, it was wonderful.
But
classic
we haven't announced our this year punishment.
So this year, the loser between us has to go to the grocery store and buy an embarrassing collection of items. Now, there is a lot of ways this can go, and I'm really excited.
I am very excited. So the winner chooses, or between the two of us, the better team chooses the items that the loser has to go and buy.
And this is not self-checkout. You gotta...
Oh, no, no, no.
You gotta run them through.
You need to interact with
people. Oh, yeah. I feel very good about this challenge. But the last 2 years, I've won. It's been more, you know, Rocky and Clubber Lang. It's just been pretty dominant, so yeah.
If you wanted a real kind of matchup, you'd say Karate Kid, you know, like Johnny and Danny LaRusso.
What? Karate Kid is so much worse than Rocky.
It's better.
But we will never do Karate Kid on this show, never.
Mr. Miyagi. I've had 0 playoff wins in the last 2 years. I need desperate help. Just help me with my fantasy draft.
You have come to the right place. We must train. You will win.
I'm ready.
Let's begin.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. Try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. And nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
Completed your training. I believe you're ready to face anyone.
Hey, good guys always win, right?
How did you find time to put that in?
I don't know. It's just I don't know how that got there. It's just it just happened.